inspiredfingers.com. Be creative. Be seen.
One thing I would like to say about me, because I like to lead by example, is that, you know, you might ask how my sounds, where do I derive my sound from? Okay, I learn from, you know, a lot of resources out there, but the major thing is that I've learned over time to draw my inspiration, okay, from God, and that's how my sound becomes different, okay? Even though I add some things that some other musicians have played, okay, because learning starts by imitation, yes, that's true, okay, but I've been able to incorporate them into my system and, you know, interpret them, okay, and interpret them, you know, through my personality, okay. I've been able to interpret them with my personality, just, you know, in the way I, you know, I flow. That's just my own way of approach to music, okay. So that's just it. I just hope you understand, even though words might fail me to explain better, but I know you have gotten the point here, okay. Make sure you make the song a meaning to you and use it as an effective way to minister to people who are worshiping alongside with you. Alright, so let's get to the song right away. Okay, What Can I Do by tribett. You can Google that out. It was done in the key of E major, and E major has its key signature as four sharps, okay? There are four sharps in the key of E major, okay? And the E major scale goes like this. E. Sorry, my voice is somehow because I'm still having cough and stuff like that. Okay, so it's not easy. So the E major scale is E, F sharp, G sharp, not E flat in this case, it's G sharp because we are talking about E major scale. Then A, B, C sharp, D sharp, not E flat in this case, and back to E. Okay, so this is your one, this is your two. This is your 3, this is your 4, this is your 5, this is your 6, this is your 7, and this is your 8 or 1, and yeah, we'll call it. We are still on the right, you know. Alright, and the song goes from the 6 to the 4 to the 1 to the 5. Okay, so that's just the major, that's the basic progression of the song. Okay, that's how the song was played. Okay, from the 6 to the 4 to the 1 to the 5. And remember, your major scale degrees, the diatonic chords in any given major scale you are in, these 2, 3, and the 6 chords, you know, they are minor chords. The 1, 4, and 5 chords, they are major chord, while the 7 is a diminished chord, okay? So you just have to understand that, okay? So, but for the 6 chord, I'll be playing C minor 7 at 4, okay? That's how I'm going to show you, okay? C minor 7, C sharp minor 7, okay, because C sharp is the 6th of the key of, you know, E, okay, so it's the C sharp minor 7 add 4, okay, there's a 4, that's F sharp with a 4, okay, so that's how it is, okay, so, what I'll be doing, instead of just calling the football, I would like break it down into, you know, my left hand, my right hand, and I will show you the fingering, okay, for each of the hand I'm using to play. Okay, so for my left hand, I'm using my pinky for the C sharp, my pointer for the G sharp, not even that, okay, then my thumb for the C sharp there, okay, then for my right hand, I'm playing the E suspended second chord, and I'm using my thumb for the E, my pointer for the F sharp, then my little finger for the B, okay, so coming all together, that's a sixth chord, okay, that's a C sharp, minor 7, add 4, okay, then it goes to the 4, I said it's from the 6 to the 4, to the 1 to the 5, okay, so for the 4 chord, it's gonna be like this, the A, E, and A, okay, so my little finger for the A, my, that's on my left hand right now, okay, then my pointer for the E, then my thumb for the A, okay, on my left hand, then on my right hand, I'm playing the B suspended 4th chord, okay, and this is the B for the thumb, the E for the pointer, for the F sharp, I'm using my middle finger, then I'm using my little finger for the B, okay, so that's the 4th chord, okay, then the 1 chord is a very, very pretty chord and easy, okay, and that's the E suspended 2nd chord, I've shown you the fingering before, okay, but let me just go, I'm just adding the power chord on my left hand, okay, and that's the E, that's the little finger for the E, then my pointer for the B, that's my left hand, then on my right hand I'm playing the E suspended 2nd chord, okay, and E for the thumb, okay, then for the F sharp I'm using my pointer, then for the B I'm using my little finger, okay, so that's my right hand, so coming together, this how it sounds, okay, then we said it goes to the 5, okay, so D sharp, okay, so little finger for the D sharp there, then for this other one it's gonna be the thumb, okay, then I'm just playing my B, remember the B major chord is the fifth chord of the key of E, okay, so I'm playing the B major chord on this, in this case, okay, so I'm just adding the B at the top, so it's still the same thing, that's the B major chord, so thumb for the B, for the D sharp I'm using my pointer, for the F sharp I'm using my middle finger, and for the last B over there I'm using my middle finger, okay, so that's how the song goes, okay, so just rewind, okay, and now I'm pretty fast, but please, I'm just trying to shorten the length of this video, okay, so rewind and get the whole fingering for everything, okay, so it goes, tell me what can I do, and I can live without you, and I can breathe without you, not tell me. Just play according to the song, okay, from my track here, so let me just play it alongside so that you can hear it, how it sounds, and while I play, okay, so here's the song.
Anybody dependent on Jesus? I mean, like, totally dependent on Jesus, and there's no point in that. It's a waste of time without him, right? Yeah. Feel free to sing with us.
All right. So go for the 6 first, okay? That's the 6. 4. For the 1. Then 5. 6. 4. 1. 5. 6.
Five.
Suspended second chord on your one, okay, just like we did for our previous lesson where we taught on what's the name of the song again, As Long As You're There by Tony McLaughlin. You can check that out, okay. We just played the one, okay, and made it the E, so that's the suspended second chord. It doesn't have to be an E suspended second chord, okay, it's just because the one is the E, okay, that's why I'm playing the E suspended second chord, okay. If it's on the F sharp, it's gonna be the F sharp suspended second chord, that's the one, okay, of the key of F sharp. So in this case, this is the one, okay, so that's why we are playing the E suspended second chord, okay. Then you play it, what I'm trying to say is that you play it all over the whole chord progression, that's your six, which is your C sharp, okay, and you play to the A, which is your four, okay, then you play it over your one, and you still play it over your five, just like that, okay, which is your B, okay. So you can play it all through, you know, some sometimes you just have to create some kind of variety to your sound. Okay, you don't have to play just the old chord that I showed you before. You don't have to play this every time. You know, you don't have to. So you can just play your hand should just be on that E suspended second chord on your right hand, okay? Your left hand, you'll be doing the movement, okay? So that's just the song. The song is a pretty song. Okay, let me just see the end of the song. It's just like a. So that's just the song. Okay. So just take it to other keys and, you know, learn for yourself, okay? So that's all. Bye.